Millions of dollars are being slashed from WA schools and teaching programs as the McGowan Budget Axe falls in education. Jobs are set to go, popular school camps will be shut down, and there's a major price hike for vacation swimming lessons.
It's moments like these that made the childhood memories of thousands of West Australians, but memories don't pay the bills. And the Point Perrin Recreation Camp is just one of six state-run camps to be shut down as part of sweeping education cuts.
I absolutely regret the decisions that have had to be made. I wish that the finances were in a better position.
18 schools will have their talented and gifted programs cut by 25%. The Schools of the Air program will be cancelled next year, and residential accommodation in Mora and Northam will close. While Tuart College, which teaches almost 1,000 mature students, will close in a year. Canning College will move exclusively to fee-paying international students, and funding for the Lansdowne Farm School has been axed.
Teachers in schools will be stunned to hear this latest announcement.
All up 170 education department jobs will go. The staff told their fate this morning, and there's a freeze on teacher promotions. They won't be able to access the Level 3 training program that ultimately leads to a major pay rise.
We're still recovering from the announcement 2 weeks ago, where the government announced 188 positions to go.
On top of that, prices for vacation swimming lessons are being hiked across the state. The 10-day programs will more than double from $13.50 to $30. Regional students find themselves at the centre of these education cuts. The Nationals have labelled it a cruel Christmas present and say that any budget savings will be spent on building another inner-city school in Subiaco. Education Minister Sue Ellery campaigned for years against Barnett government education cuts, but just 9 months into power, she's made the decision to slash $64 million over 4 years.
Budget repair is going to be ongoing. It's across government. West Australians expect us to get our financial house in order.
Those are all frontline services targeted for specific needs to our community, and she and the government is cutting those to fund what?
The changes come into effect in 12 months' time. The minister hasn't ruled out any more cuts. Michael Genovese, Nine News.